Good day, my puppies. I hope you are all enjoying your staying at home. Please stay safe. My name is Miss Olariwaju Rofia. The subject we are having now is basic science. And our topic for today is colors. Under the topic colors, we will be discussing on the colors in living things, colors in non-living things, the uses of colors, the basic color that we have, and I know you are all familiar with different types of color. Last week, we discussed about the types of soil and their properties. We have three main types of soil. We have clay soil, sandy soil, and loamy soil. Behavioral objectives. At the end of this lesson, pupils should be able to, one, understand the colors in living things, two, understand the colors in non-living things, and the third one, they must be able to list the uses of colors. Colors in living things. All the plants and animal are living things. That is, living things are the things that have life. Right? For example, an example of living things, they are plants and animal. You know, we have different plants and we have different animals like goats, sheep, and living things, they are the things that can move from one place to another. They are the things that can breed. They are the things that can grow, etc. So all these have some specific color. That is, all these living things, they have some specific color. E.g., we have red rose, white mushrooms, brown cockroach, red tomato, white duck, yellow sunflower, green leaves, green grasshopper, black goat, purple grapes. And in non-living things, they are the things that cannot move from one place to another. They are the things. Non-living things are the things that they don't have life. They can't grow. They just stay in one place. We have an example. We have candies. We have brown chocolate. We have black and white football. We have orange bowl, we have lollipops, red kite, pink candle, green balloon, marbles, etc. So color is part of our everyday lives. And we have three basic colors, which are, we have red color, yellow color, blue color. That is, when you add red plus blue, you get another color. When you add yellow plus blue, you achieve another color. When you mix red plus blue, yellow plus blue, yellow plus red, and so on, you achieve another color. Uses of color. One, we express the pictures by colors. That, like ripe fruit, on ripe fruit, you have pink ice cream, yellow flower, red bag, brown bag, etc. Different types of dyes are used to give beautiful colors to our clothes. For example, now during our inter-house sports, we have four houses. We have red house, yellow house, blue house, and so on. We can easily identify the houses through their color of our sports wear. You can be in red house and your sister may be in yellow house. Someone can be in blue house and is her sister. Her sister can be in red house and so on. So the third one, to show road signs for awareness. Most of the road signs are colored in red and yellow. You know, we have many road signs. We have U-turn, we have F, and so on. The third one, to show road sign for awareness. Most of the road sign are colored in red and yellow. Red or yellow. Traffic light to control the traffic. They symbolize three different means. Red for stop, green for go, and yellow for wait or to be ready. That is, you know, we have three main signs. When you want to cross a road, when you see in the most of our cities, there are road signs beside the roads. Red means stop. Yellow means get ready. And green means you can cross the road. The fifth one, children use different colored Lego sets to identify the colors and construct different shapes. For example, now in our crèche, we have different types of colors in our crèche classroom. We have some Lego sets, the one they use to construct houses, to construct shapes, to construct blocks, and so on. Your assignment, you list the five uses of color. Two, what are the basic types of color that we have? So our summary, we have talked about all the living things and non-living things we have. We have some specific color. Plants are green, tomatoes are red, lemon are yellow. Two, children can see different colors in candy, sweet marbles, rainbow, and kite. Wax, colors, Lego sets, and pencil can be used to recognize different colors. There are three colors in traffic lights to control the traffic. These are red to stop, yellow to wait, and green to go. We should always follow these traffic lights. Thanks for listening.